Good day. Special thanks to Chintan for beautiful introduction, and thanks to Dr. Sabu for organizing the program and giving me this opportunity to speak upon. So talk for my today's evening is slightly different. Like probably I'll be talking on more of a technology because session is about technology. So I'll be talking about Osmo laser technology and how it is going to be helpful in treating our diabetic patients. So we know that when we want to treat particularly drug like metformin, we have two kinds of preparation. One is an immediate release preparation, another is a controlled release kind of a or extended release preparation, which are basically available. So what we have in that is a very, very different kind of a scenario where the extended release, they act on a very different kind of a way. And probably because of this extended release technology, there is at times unpredictable plasma concentration, as well as this technology that interferes with the drug release by pH and food, as well as because of this, there is an increased amount of side effect. Also at times we find there is something called as a dumping of the drug which has been there in the body, which happens as a part of this extended release formulation. So scientists have done a lot of research upon that, how they can achieve a sustained release kind of a formulation, extended release formulation, using this newer drug delivery kind of a technology. And one of those technology which has come up, that is Osmo laser technology. Now, what does it mean? It is osmosis mediated oral drug delivery system technology. And how does it work? Basically, it offers drug release which is independent of motility, pH or food. So the drug has been released constantly. It has not been affected by your pH or the motility or the food. It provides a delivery rate of zero order. So there's a continuous, almost a flat kind of a pattern what we want in a sustained release kind of a drug that has been achieved using this particular technology. The delivery may be delayed or pulsed if desired. It achieves higher and predictable release rate and the high degree of in vivo and in vitro correlation, which is being seen over here. So how does this technology work basically? So it's very, very important to understand when we know that we've been talking about some particular technology, how this technology actually been working. So here you have a tablet which has a multiple layer, the overcoat of the drug, so that when it goes in the, there is an outer layer of glimepiride which has been rapidly dissolves and that comes into the blood. Then you have a semi-permeable membrane. So osmosis through the semi-permeable membrane which occurs. And then you have a layer of a metformin. And this metformin layer is Dr. Lee, we understand that there are some laser drilled hole that is there. And when the drug goes in the stomach, there is an osmosis. So there is a push layer that pushes the metformin at a constant rate. And through this laser drilled hole, the medicine metformin, which has been in a sustained release fashion, which comes out and it gives a zero order kinetic and almost a flat pattern where there's a constant release of the drug, which has been seen. So there's no peak or no tuff, which is there when it is in the stomach. Now, everybody knows that when we give metformin, there are multiple challenges with the metformin. And these challenges include a lot of GI side effect, and the GI side effect are common like diarrhea almost in 62%, heartburn almost in half of the patient, nausea in half of the patient. One third of the patient may complain of abdominal pain or bloating, and almost one fourth patient will complain of retching. So if you look overall, 72% patient reported at least one tolerability issue with the metformin. And why this? Because it was more of a immediate release, or it was something which was older form of sustained release kind of a drug which was being used in this pattern. So again, that makes it difficult in uptitrating the dose. The adherence is poor, and because of this poor adherence and difficulty in uptitration, what we have is a poor glycemic control in all such patients. So if you look at the number of data collected, more than a million of patients with a type 2 diabetes patient from 48 clinical trial, including 25 oral and 19 injectable. And it said that 30% of metformin dose were not taken by a patient to which they were prescribed. Like you've been prescribed 1,000, person is taking only 500. You have prescribed 2,000 milligram of metformin, patient is taking only 1,000 or 1,500 milligram of metformin. So 30% of the patient by themselves, because of the side effect, they were not taking. So there was a very low adherence to this metformin treatment in all such patients. And patients with type 2 diabetes on metformin were the least likely to take their required doses compared to the patient with type 2 diabetes on any other diabetic treatment. So that makes it very important that metformin is number one. Like after your diet and exercise has failed, you need to add metformin. And that particularly, say, one of the most important pillar patient has not been taking. So that makes the condition very, very disastrous for patient. And this non-adherence leads to inadequate control, increased risk of mortality and morbidity, increased cost of outpatient care, emergency room visit, hospitalization, and managing complication of diabetes. So at least 45% of patients with type 2 diabetes fail to achieve adequate glycemic control of, say, HbA1c less than 7%. And because of this non-adherence, there's also increased risk of mortality by almost 45%, cardiovascular disease almost about 40%, and all-cause hospitalization by almost 38%. Also, there is increased risk of stroke, 41%, nephropathy, 85%, and retinopathy, almost 90% of patients. Now, let us talk about the impact of non-adherence of mortality outcome. Almost in around 16,000 patients, this thing has been studied. And it has been found that hazard ratio of almost 1.6, where there's a medication non-compliance is there. So almost 1.6 fold increase in all-cause mortality, which has been seen if there's a non-compliance to diabetic therapy. So how can the medication adherence could be improved? So each 10% increase in compliance reduce HbA1c by 0.1% and annual healthcare cost by 30%. This improved compliance helps to prevent almost 2,000 deaths per 10,000 individual, as well as 152 CVD event per 10,000 individual. So the high level of adherence is an effective as addition of second anti-hyperglycemic drug in achieving glycemic control. So now that this osmolaser technology in diabetic care, there are drugs like glimepiride and metformin available in this technology. And we have a very good result using this osmolaser technology in this particular molecule. So with this, what it gives you is a predictable drug release, sustained plasma concentration for prolonged period, no dose dumping, and 30% lower Cmax level. As well as it has a lot of other benefit like lesser GI side effect, prolonged glycemic control, smoother uptitration of metformin, improved medication adherence, which has been seen. There has been a paper published from one of our colleagues, Dr. Rajesh Rajput, where this particular technology has been used for treating diabetic patients. And from studies, what he has been shown that it is one of the most promising strategy-based system for sustained delivery of drug. It appears to be promising solution for limitation of conventional extended release formulation. It offers distinct clinical advantage to the patient with type 2 diabetic patient the prolonged duration of action, thereby improving medication adherence. Also, this technology has been used for a drug like vildagliptin. We know that vildagliptin is one of the very important and most of us have been using. So if we have a technology which can give once a day vildagliptin and you have very similar kind of control, so that can again become a very important part because of the durable glycemic control, improve glycemia in elderly patient as well, in patient with moderate to severe renal impairment, and it has a low risk of hypoglycemia and it is a weight neutral kind of a drug. Till now, it was available as a BD doses, 50 milligram to be used twice a day. And again, twice a day was leading to non-adherence, again leading to inadequate control, increased morbidity, mortality, as well as increased risk of complication. So now using the same osmolaser technology for vildagliptin 100 milligram, it gives a distinct advantage. And for the first time, it is in particular technology being used with vildagliptin in this form. And here you can see the DPP-4 inhibition, which is more than 80% for 23 hours. So either galva has been given twice a day vis-a-vis vildagliptin sustained release given with this osmolaser technology, you can see a very similar kind of a response seen over here, and which helps in reducing the pill burden for better patient compliance. So we can give one tablet instead of two tablets in a day and have a better compliance. As well as the lower Cmax, which probably gives a longer span of drug availability in the serum, and there's no peak and tough kind of a thing seen over here. Now, when we compare the safety profile with a single dose versus the multiple doses, you can see a very similar kind of a profile, what we're finding over here, and which gives it as a better option. So, where it has been important, patients who are on sulfonylurea, patient with CKD, where the recommended dose could be 50 milligram once in a day. And again, this 50 milligram has been available as OD doses with this osmolaser technology. Again, similar kind of DPP-4 inhibition of more than 80%. And again, this, as I said, the submaximal through DPP-4 inhibition, approximately 25% before the next dose, which has been due. So this is a response with the 50 milligram once in a day, as compared to the 12, which has a 20 hours compared to the 12 hour with the immediate release formulation. So again, you have a better result with that. So to summarize, like osmolaser technology is a most promising strategy-based system for sustained drug release. Osmolaser technology appears to be a promising solution for limitation of conventional extended release formulation by virtue of distinguished technology features, lesser incidence of GI side effect. Vildagliptin 50 milligram sustained release reduces drug exposure with lower Cmax, improved safety profile with low drug exposure, reduced pill burden, one tablet of vildagliptin vis-a-vis two tablet. So that is again beneficial with a similar kind of A1C control and at par better 24-hour DPP inhibition for effective glycemic control with once a day. And again, a 50 milligram sustained release could be an option for people who have renal dysfunction. So that is again one another option. With this, I thank you for patience listening. I'll stop sharing over here. Thank you.